What is going on with Britney Spears? We went a long time without hearing the name that we'd all come to know and love throughout the 90s and noughties, but it seems Britney Spears should be at the front of our minds at the moment. And whilst most of the drama has taken place right in the public eye, what has remained hidden from the world is why. We know she had a tough time. We all joke about 2007 Britney and her shaving her head fiasco, but what's really going on in the life of Britney Spears? Make sure you like this video and subscribe to our channel to keep yourself in the loop with all the gossip and the info from the celeb world. And strap yourselves in, guys, because this is a lot to take in. More than a decade ago now, Britney entered into a conservatorship with her father after suffering a very public breakdown. That's a word I'm going to use a lot, so let's explain it quickly. A conservatorship is a legal concept in the United States. A guardian or protector is appointed by a judge to manage the financial affairs and daily life of another due to a physical or mental limitation or old age. A person under a conservatorship is a conservatee. So, in this example, Britney is the conservatee of her dad, Jamie. Got it? Good. And Jamie has full control over Britney's financial and medical affairs, but that's not all. And this quote from freebritney.net sums up her situation perfectly. During the 12 years of Spears' conservatorship, she has repeatedly toured the world, released multiple albums, and worked on a variety of television shows. Her conservators decide whether or not she works, as she cannot enter into contracts for herself because she's legally not her own person. Britney Spears needs permission from her conservators to leave her house or spend any of her own money. In this case, the terms of the conservatorship haven't been made public until recently, and this was something that Britney herself wanted to change. She filed to open up parts of the conservatorship, according to TMZ, and has demonstrated publicly her support for the hashtag Free Britney movement. The movement at the moment is astronomical across America, as fans and those in the know have been calling for it to end for years. There's even a petition to the White House to help end the conservatorship, and they're calling for legal intervention to help Britney regain control over her finances and her life. Some financial documents obtained by Business Insider show that Britney spent over $1 million on her legal and conservator fees in 2018 alone. But how did this all start, and what does it look like now? Let's take a look back in time. Again, we all know about that 2007 moment where she shaved her head in a very public breakdown. She then attacked a photographer's car with her umbrella. She was then put under a 5150 hold in a psychiatric hospital twice for mental health evaluations. This whole process was described as she went willingly. It was almost like she knew something was wrong at the time, and like many celebs who've been in the spotlight for a fair amount of their childhood, she had a lot to contend with. This takes us to 2008, when the conservatorship was first put in place, and it was described as temporary. Jamie, her dad, petitioned the courts for an emergency conservatorship, and it was granted. This meant that as of 2008, Jamie was given the legal right to oversee the decisions about Britney's estate and health. This includes everything from negotiating business deals and restricting who can see her. By 2009, there were already questions about the conservatorship. FreeBritney.net started questioning this right at the very beginning. From 2009 to around 2012, the conservatorship that was temporary, remember, continued to be extended. There were regular check-ins in place, and year after year, it was getting extended. In the meantime, Britney continued to work, rolling out several albums, and the conservatorship has said to have taken its toll on Britney's relationship with her dad. He says the relationship has always been strained, and if that's the case, is he really the right person to legally be in place to control her every move? Let us know in the comments below what you think. Fast forward to 2019, Jamie filed a notice of intent to extend it to Louisiana, Hawaii, and Florida, according to ET. Later in 2019, Jamie stepped down as Britney's private conservator. This came after he was accused of physically abusing Britney's 14-year-old son, Sean, and Jamie was replaced in that primary spot by Britney's longtime care manager, Jodie Montgomery. Then sources close to Britney insisted that the conservatorship is good for her, but these sources include Larry Rudolph, her manager, and Stanton Steen, her lawyer, who are both hired and paid by, you guessed it, Jamie Spears. With all the talk having resurfaced about the conservatorship 11 years later, dad Jamie became ill and Britney struggled with this. So she did a month-long stay at a mental health facility. Now to 2020. This is when the Free Britney movement really ramped things up. Britney's family literally never do interviews about the singer, especially her brother Ryan. In July of 2020, he went on the As Not Seen on TV podcast and spoke out about the conservatorship. He said, "She's been in this thing for quite some time now. Obviously, there was a need for it at the beginning. Now they've made some changes and all we can do is hope for the best." He also added that his father had done the best he could given the situation he was put in. Now, he and Britney speak constantly and are very close. He confirmed that she definitely wants out of the conservatorship. He said she's always wanted to get out of it. It's very frustrating to have, whether someone's coming in peace to help or coming in with an attitude, having someone constantly tell you what to do has got to be frustrating. Remember, Jamie has control over who Britney sees, who she dates, what she buys, so she can't even choose her own lawyer. Now it gets really tricky. Britney's dad, Jamie, wants to choose a lawyer who's been involved in this conservatorship for years to take on more responsibilities and co-conservator alongside Jamie. But Britney has spoken out saying she wants someone new and independent. Britney also wants the hearing to be public. There are no medical or sensitive issues with her children to warrant secrecy anymore. Towards the end of 2020, the Spears family were said to be at war with each other over the conservatorship. Britney filed a request to permanently replace her father with her caregiver, Jodie Montgomery, and then tried her best to make changes to the terms of the conservatorship. Right now, her mother, Lynn, believes it's time for Britney to take control of her finances and personal life, while Jamie is pushing to extend the conservatorship again. Lynn wants a care plan established that would transition Britney's personal life out of the conservatorship, says The Source. Jamie, however, has told her that Britney needs long-term monitoring, and he doesn't think that she's prepared to take such drastic action. In November of 2020, Britney lost her bid to remove her father from the conservatorship. Now Britney is refusing to perform and will continue to do so for as long as her father is her conservator. Her lawyer, Samuel Ingham, said, "My client has informed me that she's afraid of her father. She will not perform again if her father is in charge of her career." The small win here was that her dad's suggestion for co-conservator was denied, and instead a member of Britney's team was given that responsibility, someone independent just like the star wanted. The global interest from friends and fans has been huge for Britney, and she's been constantly engaging with the Free Britney movement. Every court date saw swarms of fans and supporters outside with Free Britney signs and banners, and even some A-list friends have spoken out, including Paris Hilton, who called the conservatorship not fair. The movement believe that Britney Spears is trapped in an immoral and possibly unlawful conservatorship, and it's up to them to save her. Now at 39 years old, her fans and followers investigate her social media feeds to look for clues and hidden messages behind her posts in a bid to unveil how she's really feeling or what's going on now. And the truth behind Britney's case has shocked even the legal world. Isa McCarley is an estate planning and probate attorney based in California, where the conservatorship is in place. She has said, "It does strike us in the legal profession as strange. Even in Sacramento, when I talk to legislators, they say what's going on and no one understands it." What's even more strange is that Britney's case is being adjudicated in what's called a probate court. These typically handle conservatorships of elderly people with disorders like dementia or Alzheimer's, or people with severe brain injuries. In other words, the probate court tends to deal with conservatorships that conservatees aren't likely to get out of. In cases of mental illness, conservatorships are usually handled by mental health courts, where conservators have to petition each year to renew the conservatorship. In the probate sector, however, they can go on indefinitely. So there are a huge amount of valid reasons for Britney to get out of the conservatorship. It was supposed to be temporary. That was 13 years ago now. Then there's the fact that she's afraid of her father. And Britney's sons have a restraining order against him after a physical assault to the then 14-year-old. Also, she's 39 years old and has no control over her actions, who she speaks to, her finances, or anything normal. One thing is for sure is that the Free Britney movement isn't going anywhere anytime soon. Let us know in the comments below what you think of the situation. Is it fair that she's stuck in this situation? And is she right to be afraid of her father? And we will keep a close eye on all things Britney in the meantime. Like this video and subscribe to our channel to keep updated with all things Britney and everything you need to know from the world of celebs.